to talk to Alana Greenfogel, who is on the field for us. Alana, are things as perfect there as we think?
Yeah, they pretty much are. And I want to talk to you about another fan favorite, the bees, the family of bees. It's, of course, another one of the highlights here. And I want you to meet Michael, who's the pilot of the little bee, the baby, right?
Yeah, I'm the pilot of Jolie.
Okay, so the bees are cool, and we'll talk about them in a second. But I want to talk about you, because you are a pretty phenomenal man. Tell me what your claim, your worldwide claim is.
Well, to me, I'm just a balloon pilot, and I'm out here for the fun of it, and I enjoy this, like my family out here. I grew up around balloons my whole life. My first ride in a balloon was at 2 weeks old.
And you are the only pilot in the world who flies in a wheelchair.
Correct. Yes, I my basket is a little bit different, and if you've seen pictures of it with the baby bee, it's like a chariot. It's like a ski lift is the way to describe it. And so I have to fly that, so I just fly my balloon sitting down versus standing up like everybody else does.
Amazing. So you've been in ballooning forever. It's you probably were in a balloon before you could say balloon.
Yeah,
and so what is this like for you then to make sure that something that's so important to you and so deep in your blood doesn't get you don't let any disability or anything in the world stop you from?
Absolutely. I try to spread the message that anybody can do anything, no matter what adversity you have in your life. Unfortunately, mine was becoming paralyzed from the waist down, but I made the best of it, and I'm still out flying balloons with my dad and my brother here flying balloons also. It's a family affair for me, so I'm out here basically with my extended family having a good time.
So thrilled to meet you. Okay, so now let's talk about those bees. This is one of the favorites. Three bees, the mama, the dad, and the little baby. And we just met you. You guys are blowing up the baby now.
Yeah, we're getting ready to stand them up. Joey and Lily are mom and dad. And they were presented here in 2003 at Balloon Fiesta. And then 2010, we had the baby, Jolie, come, and I've been flying it every year here at Fiesta since then.
Okay, so what do these bees do that's pretty cool that these folks are going to get to see?
They hug and kiss in the sky. Unfortunately, this morning, we're going to go ahead and stay on the ground for the crowd and everything else. So we're just going to stay here and do a static display for everybody. But that gets the people a chance to come up, check us out, and everything else. So
let me ask you about this, because this is one thing we've been talking about with Arabelle, the stagecoach, Elvis, the special shapes. Even though we're seeing so many of the more traditional shapes in the sky, what is it about the special shapes that makes it a little bit more finicky, and why perhaps today you won't be able to fly?
Today's a beautiful day to fly. Don't get me wrong. It's the direction and everything else. This isn't right. And the forecast, I mean, they're forecasting some winds to come up today. But it's going to be a beautiful day overall. What the problem with the shapes are is most of us are limited on our time that we can spend in the air and make the adjustments to find a really good landing spot. And ultimately, as pilots, we want to be safe, number one. I always say I have two rules, be safe and have fun. As long as we're being safe, we're going to have fun. As long as we're having fun, we'll be safe. So that's kind of my rule. And for the crowd, it's nothing better than to get the chance to come walk up and look at the bee and come close to us and get the cards and everything else. So.
Hey, and there's still 7 days left of Balloon Fiesta,
exactly.
So maybe those bees will make an appearance in the air.
We plan to fly every day we can. I mean, it's some days are better to stay on the ground wishing you were in the air than in the air wishing you were on the ground. So.
Michael, thanks so much for sharing your inspiring story with us, and we're so glad the bees are here and that you're here, and we look forward to seeing them up in the sky perhaps a little bit later. And so some of the other favorites, the bees, we've been seeing Arabelle in the stagecoach. We saw the elephant, which is new this year, a chocolate ice cream cone, which is also new this year. I don't know. It's a little chilly for ice cream today, but it's still a very beautiful balloon to look at. Send it back to you guys.
Hey, Alana, are you still there next to Michael? Can you ask him if Jolie's going to get a little brother or sister at some point?
Oh, okay. So I got to ask you, the crews want to know, any more baby bees in the future of this family?
If you see Joey and Lily, they just got a facelift. So they saw the plastic surgery.
Botox.
Yeah, during the plastic surgery, they were in the shop laying on top of each other. So we never know. You never know what happens. So.
Happens in plastic surgery offices, stays in plastic surgery offices.
So never know what's going to happen. I mean, there's always plans. We always have little scheming ideas and stuff like that, but we'll see what happens. The future, there's always exciting things happening.
Who knew that's how bees mate?
Yeah.
All right, so there's a tease for you. Stay tuned year after year, because Sounds like there might have been some hanky-panky going on in the doctor's office.
In the bees right now.
Plastic surgery. What is this, Orange County or something? I mean, wow. Well, that's exciting. Look at this, Tanya. We've got green. Thanks so much, Alana. Great reporting there and a great story.